you know, having monitoring on a transformer, or you know, you have some monitoring on the battery, it's all, you know, you're talking about Internet of Things. When you are able to monitor a thing through a sensor, you are able to communicate, you are able to see things, and you are able to have an analytics on it. It's what Internet of Thing is. So it's no more a, you know, big thing, it's everything, everybody's doing it. But there are a few things I just want to say. You know, one somebody mentioned that there can be n number of things and they all can be connected. But after connecting, whether it's a return on investment or not, and how will you calculate that return on investment? That's a very big challenge, and that's what we are currently working on and seeing how to do it. And when we talk about Internet of Things, we are trying to combine four industries together: the manufacturers of the devices, the communication industries. Many times, I'm sorry to say, but sometimes you might not realize that something can happen through a Wi-Fi connectivity and you might not require a SIM, okay? And you're still thinking about putting a GSM or a CDMA kind of connectivity. So, you know, it's not only a pipe which you need to just transfer data. It's much more than that. So there's a communication industry attached to it. There is a third, which is an IT services industry to create those solutions. And then the domain industry itself. If I have to create a solution for a utility, I need to have somebody from utility to make me understand what I'll be doing with the data which I can generate. Okay. I just want to give you two, three examples, and you know, the, and then I'll come to the last point. You know, we came, you know, when we speak about, and many times we are hearing that from two-digit numbers, now the solar power generation is, you know, in one digit, three rupees, 3.15 exactly as on today. You know, we went to the solar plant and we tried to identify what the current challenges they are facing. And what we realized that there are hectares of land you have the solar panels, and if any of the solar panel goes down, the, you know, the generation of the electricity goes down and there is a loss. Okay. And then the person goes on a bike, honestly, you know, on a bike, and try to search where the panel has gone down. And they will have an instrument, they'll fit in, no, this is not, no, this is not, this is not. And it used to take around 7 to 8 hours for them to realize which particular panel or, you know, the combination of panels have gone down. And if it's going to be 5 p.m. in the evening and the sun is setting, then they have to start it again in the morning. And there's a huge amount of loss that used to incur by the power plant company because of this one cell panel going down. So what we have been able to do, we worked with we are an IoT company. We came out with an idea and we created a sensor, which we are currently doing a pilot, which remotely by using the Wi-Fi connectivity, okay, we are able to monitor and we are able to pinpoint which particular panel of the whole solar plant has gone down. And that has really resulted in the efficiency improvement in one of the power plant in Gujarat. This is already in the pilot stage, and then we'll be rolling out along. And that's the kind of thing that has started happening. You know, we also mentioned about the electric bikes, you know, electric rickshaws. Somebody said that, you know, the warranty given on the batteries, okay? And, you know, when did you start? When did you open? And the cost of the battery and the amount of money they will be interested in spending to make it a smart battery, the word which is very misused today is smart. Okay, what exactly you mean by saying smart, you don't know. But, you know, to have those kind of data, when the battery was started, when what was charged, how much was the charging, what the things are happening, all that details, not the manufacturers, the manufacturers wanted it for the warranty payments. And what can be the business case for them to generate, to have that kind of cost. And the cost, they said, should be 75 cents per battery. Okay. And with India like country, and the reason why the company of ours, my company from Silicon Valley, and we are doing good in the United States, came to India, because India as a country is allowing us and forcing us to get to a cost to run a solution. And the volume is the game which we all are working. And if we are going to succeed in this country, we'll be able to succeed everywhere else in the world. Okay. And that's what the thought is. So with the solar plant, with the battery, we have been able to get to the cost, which is cost effective. But definitely, before I go to the last point, the skill set, because that was all one of the points which Mustafa ji mentioned. Because we are combining the four industries together. You know, in the IT industry, When I used to work on a banking software, I used to be taught what bank is, what is a debit account or a credit card or a saving bank and all. But when I come and start creating an IoT solution, I not only have to understand what is manufacturing, what is connectivity, what is IT services, but also that industry domain itself. And if I won't have that knowledge of, at least some knowledge of all four of them, I will not be able to create a solution which will be, you know, which will be used for the industry. So there is a huge skill gap, and that's where, you know, organization like IET, which I am chairing, are currently working on and trying to create a complete creation of IoT skilled resources who will be able to understand and work on creating IoT solutions. I just want to end before I, when we speak about, you know, Cisco and many other companies coming out, 20 billion devices get connected. The other estimate is for a 20 billion devices getting connected, there'll be 4.5 million program managers required to develop those programs, and there'll be approximately 10 million developers required to develop those solutions. Okay, and we are still not working on it, and there's a huge need for all of us to start thinking, how will we create those kind of skills? How will we be able to prepare those skills?